Good one. Look at that nice foot tuck.
One day at a time.
We watch for things like altitude.
One flight at a time.
It's turning.
This majestic bird is stretching its wings, getting ready to fly home.
Excellent.
This isn't just any bird. It's a rare golden eagle, found last November by a bow hunter across the river from Wabasha. This golden was hurt. The University of Minnesota's Raptor Center got the call.
The bird came with a leg hold trap to the right leg. Fortunately, the bone was not completely fractured.
People have occasionally seen goldens a few miles inland from the Mississippi River. In fact, Scott Mehus with the National Eagle Center in Wabasha and a group of volunteers counted more than 70 of the birds one day in January alone.
Most people don't realize the numbers of golden eagles that do spend the winter here in southeast Minnesota, western Wisconsin, and even into northeast Iowa. And over the years of me watching them, I've been trying to prove that and document that.
Some people thought maybe they were golden eagles from out west, where they're very common.
To find out where the birds were coming from, the Minnesota and Wisconsin DNRs, Audubon, Minnesota, the National Eagle Center, and Fish and Wildlife Service embarked this winter on a three-year study to trap and fit golden eagles with radio transmitters. But they came up short, except for this guy in rehab.
This is the transmitter. It weighs 70 grams. There's also a GPS unit right here.
Every 3 days, the GPS unit will upload information about the bird's location. And that will give regional researchers data they've never had before.
The most basic, really, I guess, for us is to figure out where the birds are breeding, where their origin is.
My own theory is that they nest in far northern Ontario, where they're very rare, and they are actually an endangered species.
Mark Martell of Audubon, Minnesota, carefully sews the straps together that hold the backpack transmitter on the eagle.
Let's turn them over so we can see what the back looks like. Easily get one finger under that.
A blood sample is taken, some measurements too.
27 and a half.
And then what else? A little work on the nails. All in preparation for this.
Two, three. Woo!
If they're part of this endangered eastern population, we need to acknowledge that and then take some appropriate action in terms of listing or at least realizing that we have something very special here.
He's going to be our first bird to be able to provide some of those first answers for us, and so it's extremely incredible.
I'm Denny Bear for the Minnesota DNR.